Welcome back, everyone. It's Stray Fae here with another episode of Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. In the last episode, we saved Neville from behind a curtain. And, well, we're tired from that, I guess, so let's end the day. Let's see what other adventures await. We have a brand new day, which means we probably have a new class to take. Oh.
Gryffindor.
I don't think this is gonna change much. We didn't lose anything. How'd you gain points overnight?
Ravenclaw.
I call shenanigans.
Slytherin.
Really? I've never seen this happen. They literally just rubber banded to just right behind me. Okay. This game's rigged. Alright, well, whatever. Let's just go downstairs and see what we have.
Hello, Hermione. Do you know what lesson we've got first thing?
It's defense against the dark arts, Harry, with Gilderoy Lockhart. I can't wait.
Me neither.
I'll meet you on the third floor outside the defense against the dark arts class.
Alright, we have our first, like, magic class, I guess? Like, yesterday we had broom flying. So we get to have the dark arts with Gilderoy Lockhart. Goody! Let's see, is these children have anything to say to me?
Just thought you ought to know. Some people are saying it was you who petrified Nearly Headless Nick.
Well, I didn't. Do you think I could do it? Can you do it? Hmm? Whatever. Hey, which one are you? Fred or George? Or are you Percy? I think you're supposed to be Percy.
Haven't you got defense against the dark arts first thing, Harry? Better get moving.
Your lips didn't even move. Alright, well, before we go to class, since we have a new spell, there are some cards that we can collect. So let's wander around the castle some more. Oh boy. Let's see how long this takes. We have not that many classrooms that we have to go into. And then we also have some more minigames. Oh boy. And to do the minigames, we're probably gonna want money, so. Or beans. So let's whack things on the way. Do-do-do. Hey girls, what do you have to say?
That Millicent Bulstrode's a real witch.
Okay. Who is she again? Too many characters. Oh no, they're all gonna get stuck with the girls. Really? I could get that one. Fine. Alright, let's head to the sixth floor. There should be some chest we can open. First, I'm gonna whack this globe. And they're gonna go on the desk, and I'm not gonna be able to get it. I should be able to grab that. Nope, can't open that one. There we go. It gives us a nice little target now. Now that we can open it.
Number 70, Leopoldina, Smethwyck.
First British witch to referee a Quidditch match. Is that it in this room? I'll have to come back with another spell. I should buy more stink pellets and more luminous balloons. Ugh, underpants. Because there are going to be more portions in the game where we have to sneak. And they're just going to be worse. Okay, here's the other chest. Same floor, just a different classroom.
Number 83, Roderick Plumpton.
Seeker for England Quidditch team. Holds British records for fastest capture of the snitch during game. 3.5 seconds, very nice. That must have disappointed the audience, the crowd. They're expecting like a game, like a full game, and just like 3 seconds. Hope you enjoyed that. Alright, so the next chest is in the secret area. Oh boy. Die. Oh no. This place again. I don't think it's in this room, but it doesn't hurt to check. Yeah, there was one chest in here. Can I please stun you? Flip you over. No, you're there. Yeah, there's nothing here. Doesn't hurt to check, though. It must be downstairs. Alright, now I remember. It's in this room. Yep, lets me target it.
Number 74, Montague Knightley.
Wizard chess champion. He needs a gold card. Ooh. Let's go get some beans from this magical box. As many as we can get before they can disappear. Alright, let's collect them. I think you can hit it as many times as you like, but then you gotta stop eventually to collect. Or else they start poofing. Alright. Very nice. We're gonna have plenty of beans. Alright, that's good. Alright, let us exit. The next card should be in the library. Which means we gotta go through some load screens, yay! We're gonna be at the library a lot, because, yeah, you saw around there's a lot of unlockables, a lot of spells you need. So, like, every time we get a spell, we're just gonna, like, go back to the library just to open something. It's a bit tedious, but I like to get cards as soon as possible. Hello. I can't talk to you. And you don't talk back. You're like, no, 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 don't talk to me. I just want to sit here. Is it in this room? I know there's some tapestries in here. There's a door. There's also another tapestry, but I think there's only one card in here. I'll see if there's anything we can get in here. Oh no, book. Great. Gonna lose all my beans I just got. Book. Come on out. Oh my god. Fine. I'm just gonna go for it. It's mine.
Number 11, Herpo the Fowl.
First known creator of the Basilisk. Ooh. He created the Basilisk. He is also a gold card. Book's gonna come back to life. Oh, come on! I didn't even see you on the shelf. I hate the enemies. Thanks for the pumpkin pastry game. Because you knew I was going to get hurt in this room. Get out of here before I lose any more beans. Let's see. I don't think there's anything else, but I'm just gonna take down all the tapestries. Alright, nothing. Just a nothing wall. Should I take out Lumos just in case? Nothing. Beans. I need to go to Fred and George's shop one night and get more luminous balloons. And I don't think there's anything here that we can... I mean, there's that. But there's nothing. That. And that. Ooh, a chocolate frog. I ate you even though I didn't need to. Alright, let's get out of here. We're done in here. I'm just messing around. Bye, librarian. I just broke all the bottles. Harry's the worst. There's like no kids in the library either. No one's studying. No one cares. No one cares about school. Although, if you were in a magical school, I think you'd care. The more you learn, the more power you get. Oh well. I guess it's like, for like the magical kids and magical families, it's like, I already have all this. It's no big deal. Alrighty. We'll whack more jars. I only got two. Alright, the next one should be on the first floor. It's in here. It's not a classroom, but in this hallway of rooms that are locked. Got another Diffindo chest.
Number 96, Hengist of Woodcroft.
Driven away from his home by non-magical persecutors, Hengist is supposed to have settled in Scotland, where he founded the village of Hogsmeade. The Three Broomsticks Inn is alleged to be Hengist's old home. Alright, so he made a bar. He made a famous bar. Alright. Do I want to wait for this? Alright, fine. I think we found all the cards in the school, so what's left are the minigame cards, which means we have to go outside. Go outside and see Neville. More load screens. Alrighty. What do you have to say? You're purple. Alright, you're Hufflepuff. You're supposed to be Hufflepuff in this game.
I had a remember once, but I forgot where I put it.
Ha, funny. Yeah, guys, how did you get points overnight? Jeez. They just did that on purpose, just so they would rubber band to where I was. Game. Alright, Neville. Let's do the easiest one. We got something new. We got racing. Let's do the first one, gnome dunking. It's probably the easiest one we can do. It's gotta beat Fred's record. Take that. I've been reading the second book, and yes, there was gnome throwing. I like didn't remember, but it was like only a page of like gnome throwing.
Number 13. Andros the Invincible.
Before he was a floating space monkey head, he was a Greek. Alleged to have been the only known wizard to produce a Patronus the size of a giant. Oh my. But yeah, I like how they just took that one page in the book that had gnome throwing and they just ran with it with this game. Just like mini games. You know, throw gnomes off tall buildings and into lakes. Alright, now for the next one. The one that I don't really like because I have to pay for it and it's actually kind of hard.
Hello, Harry. Like to throw some gnomes and beat the record? It'll cost 15 beans.
15? Well, I hope I don't mess this up. Alright. Let's whack you. Don't you dare hit me, guys. Alright, at least they... I like how they're aligned, so like if... As long as I get in the middle, I'm gonna get a big multiplier, but... My aiming capabilities are kinda iffy. Really? I wasn't close enough? Try this. Oh no. Go. Whoops. Well, I'm just not doing well on this. I might have to cut this out. Assuming I suck that bad and like, let me see if I get closer. Dang it. Let's hope I don't have to. Oh no, so close. Wait. Oh, right, it applied the multiplier later. Oh, I'm so glad I don't have to do that again. I'm so glad I don't have to farm more beans.
Number 16, Cliodne.
Irish druidess who discovered properties of moondew. Druidess. It makes me want to play Warcraft now. Alright. Well, I'm glad that's over with. So let's get to maybe the fun part, as long as I don't suck. Let's do some racing. Where's the kid? There's the kid. You're a little Ravenclaw girl.
Fancy a race, Harry. It'll cost 5 beans.
There we go. It's pretty cheap. So, alright, she's gonna, they're always gonna get ahead of you at first, but the main thing to do is that you want to go through the rings, and the more rings you go through, you'll start accelerating, and you'll eventually be able to catch up to her. So it starts slow at first, but it gets faster. Alright, so try not to mess this up. Whee! Like how her little broom tail there is green, like she's evil Slytherin or something. Alright, here we go. Oh god. Yeah, we're getting way faster. Down. This course is long. Any day now. Wanna see the end. It's like we're playing Superman. This is kind of a fun portion of the game. This is why they made like a whole separate game for this. The Quidditch Harry Potter game. Which I did actually find in the used game store, and I got it for $3, so I'm gonna test that out later. Hopefully it works. I didn't test to see if the game worked. Yay, did it!
You won well, Potter. Have this wizard card.
Number 22. Circe.
And we got another 10 cards. Lived in an island of Aya. That's a lot of vowels. Expert at turning lost sailors into pigs. Pfft. Wait, I remember. Was she in the Odyssey? It's been so long since I took English in high school. And like we read that. Alright, she has another race for us.
This time, it'll cost 10 beans.
And she'll ask for more money, but the course is a bit different. I think it also gets shorter as well, because like the rings are more pushed together. Which means you have less time to try to catch up, but it also means that the course is a lot shorter. Let's see how long this one is. We're getting faster, but not quite. Sharp turn. I'm gonna get ya. Come on, Harry. Alright, doing well. I'm glad that the rings aren't moving or shrinking. Although I probably shouldn't say that, because I'm probably gonna do that. It's nice and easy. Are we almost done? Yep, finish line's right there. Quick and easy. Winner!
Well done, Harry. Here's a wizard card.
Number 24. Adalbert Waffling.
Famous magical theoretician. He was only a copper card. Alright, there's still another race we can do.
I won't lose this time. It'll cost 15 beans.
I'll do it. Like, I couldn't even get the first ring because it was like before me. Alright, this is a lot more clustered together. Whee! Let's go! Yeah, we already overtook her. We're ahead. Where's the finish line? There it is. Quick and easy.
For winning the race, you get a wizard card.
Number 25, Perpetua Fancourt.
Which who invented the lunoscope? Alright, and since we did all the races, we were transported back here. I think there's another set. There is another set of races. But let's see, how many beans do I have? Let's see, I might not have enough for all three. So I'll be right back. I'm just gonna get some more beans. And we're back with more beans. More beans than we probably need. Let's go do another race. This time it's a boy. It's a Hufflepuff boy.
Fancy a race, Harry? It'll cost 5 beans.
Alright, it's pretty cheap. Yeah, I collected 80 beans. I got plenty. Oops, I missed. Alright, let's try to focus. These are a lot more clustered together than last time. Whee! Oh god. A little bit harder. But we're still catching up, that's good. Oh god! Where am I going? Alright. Let's hope he just doesn't magically boost out of nowhere. We're going pretty fast. I like how we're going so fast that we can see the rings starting to form. There's the end. Don't miss the finish line.
You won well, Potter. Have this wizard card.
Number 26. Almerick Sawbridge.
Famous for conquering the river troll that was terrorizing those trying to cross the Wye River. River troll in question believed to be one of the largest ever to exist in Britain, with the weight of 1 ton. Oh, that's pretty big. Again.
Let's race, Harry. I won't lose this time. It'll cost 10 beans.
Alright. You know, they always have a head start. I like how they kind of made the whole school an open area to explore. Let's see. Yeah, later on you will get your own little broom and you can explore the schools. Although I don't think there's anything there, so just fun to explore. All right, we finally caught up. Any day now. This one feels slower than the last one for some reason. There's the end. Ta-da! I like how much detail they put in the school too.
Well done, Harry. Here's a wizard card.
Number 27. Mirabella Plunkett.
This is a duplicate that we found back in Diagon Alley. Got another one that we'll probably trade. Yeah, I like how much detail they put in the school. Like, it looks like from the movie. We got our flying practice area. I think we saw Hagrid's. Hagrid's pretty close to the greenhouse. Alright. Alright, boy.
Harry, I won't lose this time. It'll cost 10 beans.
Oh, you're not asking for much. Let's go! Alright, this one's probably gonna be a short one because all the rings are smooshed together. Oh, but here we go. Here we go. Oh god! Oh god, we're going too fast! Can't see the ring, son. Oh no! Okay, let's get what we can. Get what we can and stay straight. Don't want to miss the goal. We're going too fast. The rings can't even keep up. There we go. She was really far back.
Here's a wizard card.
Number 30. Artemisia Lufkin.
First witch to become minister for magic. Wait, do we already see this one? No, it was... I thought we already saw a witch who was first become minister of magic. Maybe this is just me. It's probably my imagination. That the last race? Yep, that's the last race. Alright, I think I'm going to stop it here. I know we didn't get to do any of the story. But we got some more cards, and we got to do a lot of broom racing. So, in the next episode, we're gonna go to our dark arts class. Alright, hope to see you there. Bye-bye.